SAP Business Partner. Over to you. So what exactly Business Partner means, and what are the transactions involved in ECC systems and S/4HANA systems? How exactly the Business Partner is behaving in ECC system, and how it's going to be different in S/4HANA. The third one is S/4HANA migration from Business Partner perspective. So if you are moving from your ECC system to S/4HANA, then from Business Partner perspective, what and all steps need to be taken care of. The next one is some customizing and settings relevant to Business Partners. Then CBA transactions and database tables relevant to customer vendor master, then address management, also Business Partner and CBA. And then we have some bodies and IDOCs like DepMas, Cremas, IDOCs. The last one is payment cards in Business Partner. So let's move on to SAP Business Partner. So a Business Partner is someone who is involved in business directly or indirectly. So it can be a vendor, customer, employee, whoever is involved in your business, they are called Business Partners. And Business Partner can hold different roles. So one Business Partner can be a customer as well as vendor and so on. So this is a typical Business Partner screen, which you can find it in SAP system in the transaction DP. So it contains the tabs such as address, address overview, identification to enter the tax details, etc. So why Business Partner? So if we have customer vendor, and when we move to Business Partner, what are the advantages which we are going to get? So in the Business Partner, we can have the data address independent, communication data, so which is not possible with the customer or vendor master. Likewise, we can have the time dependency. For this year, Business Partner address will be so-and-so. For next year, it can be a different one. So those kind of time dependency can be used in the Business Partner. And we have various relationships in Business Partner, but in the customer or vendor master, it is restricted to contact person relationships. Here we have n number of roles and relationships. And we can have multiple roles and addresses, which is not there in the customer or vendor master. That is why we have moved on from customer master and vendor master to Business Partners. So let's see some differences which you can find in ECC and S/4HANA systems with relevant to Business Partners. So in ECC system, you can access customer master through these transactions XD01, XD02, XD03, same like vendor master, we can access through XK01, XK02, 02, 03 in the typical ECC system. Also, we have the Business Partners in the ECC system. If the synchronization is active and if the customizations are proper, based on the and BP group settings, Business Partners will be created in the ECC system. Also, the most important thing is the number range, which should be defined accordingly. But in S/4 system, it is not possible to access the transactions such as XK01, XD01, 0203, because it automatically directs you to the transaction BP. So it is not possible to access these transactions in S/4 system. So Business Partner in S/4 system looks similar like in ECC, in the transaction DP. And we have different roles such as FLCU01, FLBN01, CU01 is for customer, standard role for the customer, and BN01 is for vendor master. So in S/4 system, vendors will be, customer and vendors will be automatically created when synchronization is active and if all the required fields are filled in the Business Partner side. we have mass updates, which is same as in ECC systems. So even in S4 systems, we have mass updates using these transaction XP99 and SK99. Otherwise, you can go to the transaction mass and make use of these object types, BUS1006 for business partner, and then KNA1 for customer, LSA1 for vendor, and so on. So mass update works in a similar way like in the ECC system. So there is some changes with the tax number mapping. So in S4 system, there are different types of tax categories which you can maintain under the identification tab. So for instance, when you maintain a tax category IN3, if the customer BP country code is IN, and when you maintain the tax category as IN3, then the field is going to be, the value is going to be saved in the field KNA1 or LSA1 SPCD3. Likewise, when we maintain the tax category as DE0, which is nothing but the VAT, then it is going to be stored, value is going to be stored in the field SPCEG. Likewise, for 1, we use SPCD1. For DE2, we use SPCD2. Then 3, 4, 5, so on. We have separate tables like KGAS and LFAS for the customer and vendor VAT numbers. For example, if the customer is from Germany and they have the VAT number of a different country from the European region. So, say customer is from Germany, but they want to maintain their tax VAT number of Spain. In that case, they can give SP0 and maintain this value, which will be saved in these KNAS and LFAS tables. Let's see some examples in the SAP systems about these business partners and differences. So this is our ECC system. So in the ECC system, we can just find a customer and its relevant business partners. So as you can see, we can access both the business partner and the customer vendor master relevant transactions in the ECC system. But in S4 system, this is our S4 system. So when we try to access business partner, customer or vendor master relevant transactions, it will automatically redirect you. Here you can find that when you enter XV01, we get an error message saying that redirecting to transaction BP as transaction XV01 is obsolete. So once we click on OK, then it will automatically redirect to the BP screen. So this is the typical BP screen, and you can find the existing BPs through a search over here. Here you can find the details of this BP, and we have multiple roles, such as for customer we normally use the FLCU00 and FLCU01 in the standard, and FLDM00 and FLDM01 for the vendor. So for example, the tax numbers which are mentioned, we can go to identification tab, and there is a separate table called tax numbers. Since this BP is from the country code IN, I can maintain an IN tax category. Now, when I say this value will be saved in KNA 1 STCD 3, since I have given the tax category as IN 3, it will be saved in the field STCD 3. And we can find the customer which has been linked to this DP in this tab. So here you can find that customer iPhone 123 is assigned to this business partner 153035. Normally in SAP, we suggest you to use the same number. Like when the business partner number is 153035, then we suggest you to use the same number where customer number also should be 153035, but it's not mandatory. Moving on to the next one, S4 HANA migrations in business partner. So there are two types of migrations. One is greenfield and another one is ECC to S4 HANA conversion. So in the case of greenfield migration, you are directly implementing the S4 HANA systems. In this case, we can directly create the BPs using the data services, web services, IDOCs, and you can also create it manually. And through CVA synchronization, all those BPs will be converted into customers, vendors, contact persons, etc. So when it is a greenfield migration, we are directly implementing the S4 HANA systems. In the case of ECC to S4 migration, before migrating, we need to ensure all the customer, vendor, and contact has a BP assigned. So in the ERP system, before migration, we have to ensure all our customers, vendors are linked to a BP. Once it has been linked, then we can move to the, we can migrate it to S4 HANA. Further steps on this will be explained in the further slides. So basically, we divide it into four steps: preparation step, synchronization step, conversion step, post-processing step. So in the preparation step, we do implement the pre-check reports, and we will ensure that all CVA enhancements and business functions are active, and we ensure that customizing, like same number customizing. If you want the BP and customer vendor master to be the same number, all those customizing has to be checked in the preparation phase itself. In the synchronization phase, we will ensure all the customer and vendor master are assigned to a BP. In the conversion, we check the pre-check reports. Pre-check reports, there are pre-check reports like the CVA underscore upgrade underscore. So these kind of reports are distributed, and we will ensure that all the customers are assigned to a business partner. And then using the SIM tool, it's been migrated. Using the SIM tool is more of a basic task which can be done by them. The last phase is a post-processing step. So once we move to S4 migration, we have to activate the synchronizations from BP to customer so that in S4 system, we can directly create the BP. It is not possible to create a customer or vendor. So once you activate, whenever you create a BP, those BPs are converted to linked to create, those BPs will create the customer and vendor master as well. So let's see each and every phase more in detail. So this is the preparation step. So in the preparation step, we have to ensure the main business part, business functions like CA underscore BP underscore SOA, those business functions should be active. Then define the number ranges, what number range you expect your BP to be, and what are the number ranges for customer and vendor master. Then we can use this report. We can create this report CVA underscore upgrade underscore check underscore resolve. And then in the synchronization step, we do the synchronization through this report CVA underscore upgrade underscore check underscore resolve, or through the synchronization cockpit, which is transaction MDS_load_copy. In case of any errors due to the data mismatch or customizing, then those errors has to be resolved and then we can execute the transaction once again. This note 22.11.312 will be helpful on this phase. So in the pre-check conversions, conversion phase, we do pre-check as well as the zoom tool. Conversion process must be triggered as per the S4HANA conversion guide. Then the last step on the post-processing step, we need to activate the post-processing from the direction of VP to customer or vendor master. As I said earlier, since it is possible to create only VP in S4 system, it should create the customer as well as the vendor once the VP has been created. Then VP customizing must be consistent, including the field attributes like if a VP is set as hidden, VP field attribute has been set as hidden in the transaction BUCG, then those kind of settings can be seen over here, has to be checked over here. So these are the some help documentation and notes if you are migrating to S4HANA. From business partner's perspective, you can go through these notes which will be helpful before the migration. So let's see some important customization relevant to these business partners. In traditional ECC system, we have these transactions OVT0 and OMLC, which is used for customer account group and vendor account group. In these account groups, we maintain the number ranges. We maintain which field should be hidden, which field should be optional, and which one is a required field. All those settings can be maintained in these customizations. Likewise, in the BP screen, we can use this customizing, define groupings and assign number ranges. In this, based on the account group and BP grouping, the number range will be defined. So there is the same number flag which can be set here. So you can go through this guided answer 244084, which helps to find out how to maintain the customizing for the fields to be hidden or required or optional. So we need to activate the synchronization so that once you create the BP, with the role SLC001, it should create a customer. So to activate the synchronization, this is just customizing where you can see that. So ensure that you are activating the synchronization option for customer to BP, vendor to BP, BP to customer, and BP to vendor. Then now you need to activate the post-processing order. So the main useful for this PPO is useful to find out whether there is any error while processing the PP or customer or vendor master synchronization. So when there is any error, we can use the transaction MDS_PPO2, which we will be seeing in the further slide. So using the transaction, we can find out whether any error is there for the required field check, all those things can be checked over there. So to activate that, we need to look at this customizing and set the flag for activating the PPO request. So there is a customizing for contact persons as well. So you can find this customizing contact person under the customer, but this is common for both customer and vendor. So if you are using from your business perspective, if you are using vendor contact person, then this is same for both. So once you activate the assignment of contact person, it is same for both customer and vendor side. So there is no separate customizing from vendor contact person perspective. It is same. It is common for both. and you need to ensure that this flag is set. Only then the contact person synchronization will happen. So here we see some of the number range settings. So based on the number range from BP to customer, so based on the BP grouping to customer account group, we can define the number range over here. Likewise, based on the BP grouping and vendor account group, the customizing can be maintained in this path. If you have the option, or if you want the option of same number flag, where the BP and the customer number should be same, or BP and vendor number should be same, then there is a same number flag which is available in this customizing. Once you set that checkbox, then whenever you create a BP, the same number customer has been created. Also ensure that number range settings are same at the account group level and the BP grouping. If the number range settings are not the same, then system will not allow you to set the same number checkbox. It will throw an error. So ensure that number range settings are same from account group and BP grouping perspective. So we have another customizing in this path, and direct transaction is BUCG. So as I said earlier, this is similar with the transaction OMSG, OVP0, like we have in the vendor account group and customer account group. We have the similar kind of a transaction for the BP role wise. You can maintain it here. Based on these settings, a field can be set to required field, optional field, or internal hidden from BP role perspective. So you can set for FLGU00, you can set a field mobile number as hidden, then it will not be shown in the BP screen. So even after migrating to S4 ANA systems, if you still want these settings should work based on the account group, and you don't want to work based on the BP role, then you can implement this node 251.6.6.06. There are some manual steps which needs to be taken care of. So once it has been done, system will work based on the account group, not based on the BP role. So this node is very important if you want your business to work based on the customer or vendor account group instead of BP role. Now let's see some CVA transactions and database tables. So this is the transaction which I mentioned earlier, MBS PPO2. So only when post-processing order is active, then you can find these kind of error messages in the transaction MBS PPO2. For example, we'll go to transaction. So this is the screen, how it looks like. You can give the range from created on. Or we can give it based on the CVA process which we are doing. So now we can find that these are the business partners which are stuck with an error. So the business partner number is 133254. And we can find the IRP assignment is a required field, but it is not maintained yet. So whatever values we store in the BP will not be saved because of this error. So there are some cases customers do enter some fields in the BP screen and save. Those fields are not saved. It is cleared when they are saving, and it will show this error customer specific data were not saved due to error CVA_APIW03. So whenever you get this pop-up in the BP screen, whenever you get this pop-up, then please go to transaction MDS_PTO2 and check what's the error you are getting. So through post-processing order, only you can find out the exact error which is causing this issue. So when you get this pop-up, you can go to this transaction and check the error and act accordingly. There's one more transaction now for synchronization, MDS load cockpit. So once the synchronization is active for all the four, then you can find the business partner to customer, business partner to vendor, likewise customer to business partner and vendor to business partner in this transaction. Here you can find there are four different options, mainly business partner to customer, business partner to vendor, customer to business partner, and vendor to business partner. So you can execute this as a background processing, and also test run is available. So once you can enter the, for example, you have a vendor and you want to create a business partner for this vendor, then you can go to the option vendor to business partner. You can enter the, based on the account group, vendor, or the deletion flag. Specified values, equal values, and we can enter the vendor number over here. And once you execute, then it will create the business partner for the vendor. If the system already having a business partner for the vendor, then it will not create. It will just try to update the existing values if there are any changes. Otherwise, it will not create a duplicate business partner. So once we execute, we can go to this tab monitor. Here we can see, this is similar like MDS_PTO2. If there are any error in the synchronization, those details can be displayed over here. And through this, we can navigate to MDS_PTO2 transaction. So the four important things over here is business partner to customer, business partner to vendor, customer to business partner, and vendor to business partner from business partner perspective. So mainly this is a MDS load cockpit is being used when you want to create BP or customer vendor master for a multiple records through a background job, or for multiple records through foreground also it can be used. But it's mainly used for multiple records. When you want to create it for the bulk, in bulk, then MDS load cockpit can be used. If you want to use it for a single customer or single vendor supplier, then we can make use of these transactions, FLBP D1 and FLBP C1. So here we can enter the customer number, and once we click on the create business partner, it will check whether this customer is already linked to any business partner. If not, system is going to create a business partner with the role FLCU01 for this customer. Likewise, we can use the transaction FLDP C1 if you want to create the business partner from a vendor or supplier, for a vendor or a supplier. The only difference between MDH load cockpit and these two transactions are, in MDH load cockpit, you can do it for a bulk of entries, but in these transactions, you can create it only one at a time. So we have two more CVA transactions. Like you already have a customer, you already have a business partner, and you want to link this business partner with that customer. Then we can make use of this transaction FLBP T2 and FLBP C2. So when we go to FLBP T2, here you can give the business partner number which you want to link with this customer, give the customer number, and then you can give the customer role. So we can give FLCU00. Once you click on the link, then this business partner will be linked to this customer master. Same with transaction FLBP C2. So this is for the vendor or supplier. So when you have a business partner and a supplier, and the link is missing between this business partner and supplier, then we can make use of this transaction to link both these. Once this link has been created, it will create an entry in the CVA table. Otherwise, the link will not be available in the CVA table. Only after making a link through these transactions, the link will be there. Then we have a transaction like MBS_link, which is very useful. If you have a business partner and if you want to know customer which has been linked to this business partner, then we can make use of this transaction MBS_link. So here we have different options, like whether we want to find a business partner, whether we want to find a customer, vendor, or contact person. Let's say I want to find a business partner in this scenario, and this business partner mapped it to customer. And since I have given mapped it to customer, I need to give the customer number over here. Say my customer cust iPhone 123. And when I execute, you can see that business partner 153035 is mapped with this customer cust iPhone 123. Likewise, we can check it the other way around also. Like if you want to find a customer which is linked to this business partner, so we can enter the business partner so that we can see that business partner is mapped to this customer cust iPhone 123. Because we have options to find out with all the permutations and combinations for business partner, customer, vendor, and contact person. And we need to enter the number, without which it will not work here. So some database tables which are mainly used from business partner perspective. So BUT00 is the main table once BP has been created. So the important fields in BUT00, like it will have the general data, it will contain the person number and the address number. And we have a BUT020, which will have the address data. Then if you have the time dependent active in your system, then you can check the table BUT021_address. Likewise, we have different tables for bank details. BUT100, if you have a BP and if you want to know to which roles this BP has been extended to, then you can make use of this table, BUT100. So once you enter the BP number, then it will show what under roles this BP has been extended to. For instance, if you have a business partner which has been linked to customer as well as vendor, then once you go to BUT100 and enter the BP, it will show the roles FLCU00, FLCU01, FLBN00, FLBN01. All these things will be shown in this database table, BUT100. Likewise, we have BUTOCC for payment cards. These are the important tables from business partner perspective. So from address details, there are a lot of tables, very important things, your ADRC table and ADRP. And then there are different tables from ADR2, ADR3 up to ADR13. So each will contain a different values. For instance, ADRC table will have the email address. Like, while each table has their own data which will be stored over here. All these are communication tables. The next one is customer master tables. So this is a KMA one is an important table for the customer master, and we have different tables like bank details, contact person, VAT registration number, all those things for the customer master. So one important thing, not all the tables are in the scope of master data synchronization. So few tables from the vendor master perspective. So LFA1, LFBK, contact person, all those things can be will be helpful when you want to see from the vendor master perspective. So these are the CVA tables, which that are some of the tables we are not aware of, like a CVA cust underscore link, which will have the link between the customer and BP, as I said earlier. So once we have a BP which is linked to a customer, then we can make an entry in CVA underscore cust underscore link. Likewise, when there is a BP to vendor link, then we can make, you can see that entry in this table, CVA underscore vend underscore link. So if you have a contact person for a customer or a vendor which is linked to the BP, then these tables can be useful. So like that, we have other tables like account group to BP grouping, account group supplier, customer account group to BP grouping, which can be used for the number ranges, and the customer account group to BP roles. During synchronization, if we want to create the BP to which roles this BP has to be extended, can be maintained through this table. As we found some customizations already, these are the tables in which it will be stored. So let's see some bodies and IDOCs with the business partner's perspective. So these are some of the important bodies. The very important body over here is CVA underscore map underscore legal entity. So this body has been used to link a customer and the supplier to a single business partner. So if you have a business partner which needs to be extended to both the customer and the supplier, then this body should be used. So normally in the ESCO systems, this body is not available by default. So this body can be implemented based on this by implementing this node 2363892. So this body will have a lot of checks. It will, for instance, it will check whether the postal code of customer and the postal code of supplier are same, so that it will can be linked to a single business partner. So SAP has provided a standard prototype through this body. If you have a business requirement where you don't want to perform any checks, then feel free to modify this body, so that you can link your customer and supplier to a single business partner. So you can do a modifications based on your business requirement in these bodies if you want the same values check need to be avoided. Likewise, we have some bodies, CVA map, bank details for title, then for default values, custom mapper, all those things, we have different bodies and APIs. So from API perspective, this is the CLMDBP maintain class, and the method name is maintain. So through this, you can create the BPs in ESCO system. So if you want further information on this API CLMDBP maintain, then you can refer this note 241-7928. Like we have DEBMAS and PREMAS IDOGs in the existing ECG system, the same IDOGs are available in S4 system. So you can use those IDOGs if you want to, or during the migration process, if you want to send the data from non-S4 systems, you can use these IDOGs. But within S4 systems, we request to avoid these IDOG, because these DEBMAS and PREMAS, if you are sending the data from a non-S4 system to S4 system, then you can use this DEBMAS and PREMAS. Within the S4 system, if you want to create the BP, then either you can create it through transaction BP, or you can make use of this API CLMDBP maintain. And we have web services as well through which it can be done. So after this, we have payment card in business partner, which will be taken by my colleague Sonal. Thank you.
Thank you, Balaji. Hello, everyone. Let's walk through the overview of payment card in business partner. So business partner gives you an option to maintain the payment card, which makes it easy if the BP is being used in any application or transaction. So the usage would be easy in all these transactions. And we all know that payment card is any card which is used for the payment, right? So with this comes the concept of old and new world card. So user has an option of choosing between the old and new world card. So old world card is nothing but there's no concept of encryption and masking. So when I say this, it means that the data is treated like any other data set. So the data is stored in a raw format. Okay? And a PCI, that is the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard, had a guideline that if any industry is using the payment card, then they should not store the data in raw format, and the encryption and masking should be used. Okay, so new world card is nothing but the enhancement of the old world functionality. So from the table perspective, old world has two tables. One is Butto CC, and the other one is C card. Butto CC is nothing but a linking table between the business partner and the payment card. And C card it contains the card information. And if you see in new world, we have Butto CC again, and there are set of few more tables involved. We will see each of this in detail. So how do we enable old or new world card? So if you go to SC43 transaction and give area menu name as PACA, yeah, and then go to application, it will display this particular view. Okay, in this view you have card and PACA. Now if you click on card or PACA, there is a button called active. So if either of this is active, then you know your system is in which particular world. So when I say card, it means old world, and when I say PACA, it means new world. Okay. Apart from this, there are certain customizing as well in this particular part. So if you go to customizing and basic settings, there are certain customizing that could be maintained in terms of payment card. For example, say you have Visa, MX, or any other card. That can be configured here. Again, MX card can be a debit card or a credit card or a food card. So even this particular configuration can be maintained here. Apart from that, every card would have a checking rule. For example, Visa maybe it would start with four digits should be a country, or the last two digits should be something else. So all these checking rules can be maintained here. Apart from that, if in case you want to maintain the reason for blocking the card, for example, if your card is misplaced or stolen, so all this customizing could be performed in this particular part. come back to the concept of old world cars. So as I said, in old world, we do not have masking or encryption, but we partially downported the masking. So in new world, we have a provision of masking and encryption, but this didn't exist in old world. So the masking concept was a little downported, meaning you can, the data will be a format itself, but in the UI, the user can view the card in masking format. Okay, so the data, as I said, will be stored in raw format in ButtoCC table as in 3-card table in the field CNUM. And ButtoCC card grid will be empty in old world. Okay, and but there is a, since there's a concept now of masking, so if you go to this particular path in ESCO, that is make security settings for payment card, then you will be navigated to this particular screen here. I would like to explain each of the fields because these fields and this screen is common even in new world. So here the first field is security level. If this is zero, which means the data is shown as it is. If it is 1, which means 1 or 2, which means that the card number will be displayed in a masking format. Okay, so if you see here an example, the card number is masked. There is a default masking settings which are done. For example, if you click on 1, this would be 5 digits visible and last 2. But if you want to change the visibility of the digits, then you can set at start and at end. So if I set at 2, which means my first 2 digits are displayed and rest will be masked, and at 3, which means my last 3 digits will be displayed and rest all in the middle are masked. So second option is access log. Now when a card is masked, a third button in this particular screen will be visible. So when you click on this card number, this will generate a pop-up which will have card number details. Okay. Now, if you want to know who are the users who have viewed this particular card details, then you can select one in active log. What this would do is, it would capture the information as in which BT, who was the user, and what time this particular data was viewed. So this will be stored in a table called CCSEC_log. Okay, and there's also a report, there's also a transaction SSPEC_log_show, which would again show the same information. So once you select this, the login will be captured in the table. As I said, on click of this card number, this would display a pop-up which would show the card details. Now, if you want to restrict the users from viewing the card number by clicking on this button, then you can select this particular checkbox. So what this checkbox would do is, it would see whether the user has the authorization to view this particular card detail. So if a user, there's an authorization object called BSCCSEC03. If the user has this particular authorization object and if this particular checkbox has been set, only then we can view the details. Okay, the next transaction is SSCCSEC log delete. So if in case you have been logging the information from 5 years or so, and you have decided that you no longer need that particular information anymore, then you can run this transaction to delete the log, provided that it should not be less than a year old. The next concept is new world card. We already know that new world has a provision of masking and encryption. So the table, the table level difference is now in Bato CP, card number, card grid is filled, but CP num is empty, which is different from the old world concept. In new world, we can encrypt based on the card level. Meaning, if I want encryption only for my MX card, then I have to set that in the customizing. So, the entries in the table would be different. For example, now I have a Visa card and I have not set encryption for my Visa card. In that case, in PCA table, the entries will be as it is. For example, the mask number will be the raw value itself. The cryptic value will again be the raw value. Now, if in case I have set encryption for my MX card, then the value will be from the database level, the value will be masked. So the table will have a masked value. The cryptic number field value would be the cryptic value. And we could also contain the length of the cryptic value. So this we can make out how the QR is. Even if the user has access to the database, he still can't view the card details. And as I said that from card level, you can maintain the setting for encryption. So that would be done in this particular part itself. In maintain payment start time, there is a column called encryption. So here you have to set the flag. Okay, so as I said that this screen, is common for new worlds as well, meaning that if in case the card is set to encryption and nothing has been maintained here, still the value will be displayed in the masked format in the DP transaction. Okay, so encryption and masking goes hand in hand. The default would be 5 digit and 5 digit, and the last 2 digits will be masked. But if you want to change from say first 5 to first 2 or last 2 to last 3, then you have to again go to this particular path and change it accordingly. So this would change the masking format. And even if there are certain cards which are not set to encryption, then if you have maintained the setting here, then the masking would be shown in the UI. But from the table level, it would still have the raw value. So now let us look at the report. RCC underscore migration. So this report is used to move the data from from C card to PCA. So meaning we are moving from the old world to the new world. So it pulls the data from Bato CC and C card to Bato CC and PCA, the new world tables. So suppose in my old world, I have 4 types of cards. Example, MX, Diner, Visa, MasterCard. Okay, and in my new world, I want the encryption active for MX. So in that case, before running the report, I have to set this particular flag, that is the encryption flag. And then when I run the report encrypts accordingly. And all this can be seen in, this will be logged in SLG1. So you can view the logs. And if you're already in the new world and when you try to run the report, then it shows you an error that the credit card encryption is already active. So you'll not be able to run the report. The second report, that is PCA underscore mask underscore crypting. Suppose I'm already in the new world and my MX card has no encryption active. Now, if I want to set encryption, question. Active for my MX card. So future MX card, whatever I have, I fill, that would be encrypted. But what about the past MX card that when that we created earlier? So if I want even that to be converted, that is to convert a non-encrypted value to the encrypted value, then I have to run the this particular report. And before I go to decrypt, let me quickly show you another transaction, that is S-Trust. So this particular transaction, it's a framework to register the algorithm. So if you want to register the algorithm for certificate, S-Trust is a transaction. Coming back to the decryption. Now, if you have algorithm A and you want to change to algorithm B, so in that case, algorithm B cannot decrypt the cards which use algorithm A. So in that case, you have to decrypt it, change the algorithm, and encrypt again. So this can be done using the transaction, this particular transaction code, the report. Now, as I gave, as I said, one of the examples which we saw that there were changes in the algorithm and you have to run the report. But then comes third world, which is the enhancement of the new world, which we just saw, wherein you don't have to do that. So there would be a requirement where you have to periodically change the keys. So that is nothing but key versioning. So say my, say I want to, or my organization, wants to use first 6 months key one and to encrypt the data and second half of the year key two. So this, by this we are trying to make it more secure. So this periodical change can be done using key versioning. So to set this active, we have a switch called PC_KEYV. If this is set to active, then in the earlier part which we saw, that is here, there would be one more flag called key replacement active. Okay, you have to set this flag as well. So once these two requirements are set, then key versioning is available in your system. So please note that this particular business is irreversible. And so the other important transaction is in SN30, if you go to SSFVARGS, so this is the particular screen. Here you can create a key in a key versioning and also length of the key. Here we will now see two reports. So the first report is RCTSEC_ENC_RE0. So if in case you want to move from the previous world to this particular world, that is key versioning, then you can run this particular report. So here, as I said, that you can have multiple keys at a given point in time. So for example, I can have 10 cards with key 1, other 10 cards with key 2, and the other 10 cards with the current key. So here it is possible that you don't have to change or decrypt your cards like in the old in the other world which we saw. Here you can live with it. So if, for example, from 2017 to 2018, I have created key 1 and I want to change to key 2. Now I can still live with key 1 and there is no need for me to decrypt. So the next card which I create, it would be in the current key version. And this would also, if you see in the table PCA_security_raw, this would have a field called key version. So for key one, it will read the card and decrypt also with key one itself. The other report is RTC SEC underscore ENC underscore RE1. So suppose I have key 1, key 2, key 3, and my current key is 3, key 3. Now if I want all my key 1 and key 2 to come to key 3, so all my older keys will be decrypted with their respective keys and encrypted with the current key. So these are the three different worlds which we just went through, and